Hey, do you know why Frankenstein's monster liked to wear a watch? Because they're both made of seconds. What? You don't like sophisticated humor? Are you looking for a suitable watch to wear while out trick-or-treating on Halloween? Or maybe you're just a macabre sort of person. What watches are available that depict monstrous imagery? Let's find out on this episode of Adventures with Tom. Talking about skeleton watches or Frankenstein watches, those made of parts from other watches. If you are watching this video on the day it was published, then tomorrow is Halloween, and my treat to you is to show you a few watches that you might want to wear out trick-or-treating, or perhaps at a costume party, or maybe you're into the goth style and wear scary clothing all the time. Let's start out with what you can find that is affordable. This way, if you only wear these watches once a year, you don't have to break the bank. One can find a lot of watches on the internet that are under $50 US, whether it be from Etsy, Amazon, AliExpress, Pinterest, or other websites. You can get watches that depict virtually any horror image you like, including spiders, scarecrows, vampires, and bats. You can even get a watch with my friend Frankie on it. What's that? You say you want a higher quality watch, not one of those cheap watches? Okay, let's see what we can find for you. But beware, what might be more scary than the look of these watches is their price tag. Don't say you haven't been warned. It appears that at the higher end, most watches use a skull imagery. Let's start out with the well-known brand Hublot. If you're into watches, you know that people either love or hate Hublot. But I'm not here to discuss that. I want to show you the Hublot Big Bang Calaveras Portrait, released in 2017 for Dia de los Muertos, or Day of the Dead. Day of the Dead is a holiday celebrated throughout Mexico to honor those that have left life before us. The Calaveras Patria was available in models in stainless steel, ceramic, and 18-karat gold. The Calaveras Patria came in a 44mm case with the dial offering an engraved skull and the bezel having Mexican imagery. Certainly a watch that will get lots of attention on your wrist. What can't be seen from the front is the Hublot caliber HUB21 movement visible from the display case back. Also, what you can't see is its price. The Calaveras Patria retailed from $12,000 US for the steel model to over $35,000 US for the gold models. If you're looking for a watch that is more elegant than scary, take a look at the Fiona Kruger Petit Skull. Fiona Kruger is a designer who hand makes her watches in Switzerland. She has several watches in her skull collection, with this Petit Skull model limited to 18 pieces. The stainless steel case outlines the shape of the skull with the crown at the top of the skull. The dial is composed of multiple guilloche pieces which give dimension to the skull. The eye cutouts allow views of the balance wheel and mainspring, which brings life to the dial. The rhodium-plated and perlage work create the teeth to complete the skull imagery. Finally, the display case back provides a view of the automatic movement and its rotor. Retail price for this designer watch is $12,000 US. If you're looking for a watch that is a bit different in several ways, you should consider HYT watches. HYT is a brand that produces hydromechanical timepieces. What the heck are hydromechanical timepieces? These are watches that use mechanical movements to push liquids through capillaries to indicate the time. And to double down on being different, here is one of HYT's watches from their Skull series. Let's look at this Skull Maori model a bit closer. This watch is named after the Maori people of Polynesia and New Zealand. I believe it was launched around 2016 with an original price of $120,000 US, with a 51mm titanium and red gold case. So how does this hydromechanical watch actually work? Hours are indicated through a series of fluid-filled tubes which act as hour markers. the mechanical movement attaches to bellows which expand and contract to move the fluid through the appropriate hour tubes. Although there is not a minute indicator, the skull's left eye shows running seconds and its right eye uses translucent colored inserts to indicate the amount of the 65-hour power reserve remaining. It gets darker as the reserve drains. HYT launched its first watch, the N1, in 2012. Sadly, they went bankrupt recently. As I said, this watch is truly out of the ordinary in many respects. In 2018, Chopard came out with their own tribute to the Day of the Dead celebration. This is the L.U.C. Perpetual T-Spirit of La Santa Muerte. This one-of-a-kind piece is in a 43 18-carat rose gold case with heavily engraved bezel, case sides, and crown. But the focus of this watch is the dial, which represents the Aztec-style skull. This skull has lots of detail to appreciate. The mouth is adorned with mother-of-pearl teeth. But notice the missing tooth. The eyes are formed by two subdials in the image of a sun. These subdials provide an AM and PM indicator, day of the week, month, and an indicator for leap years. On the skull forehead is the date complication. The watch is powered by the L.U.C. 02.14-L caliber, a manual wind perpetual calendar tourbillon with 9 days of power supply. This movement can be seen along with the power reserve indicator through the display case back. This unique piece was priced at 232 euros, or about $270,000 US. Many of you will wear a Richard Mille watches. Founded in 2001 and based in Le Bralux, Switzerland, is known for creating recognizable watches through their case shapes and spine screws. In 2012, Richard Mille unveiled the Tourbillon Skull RM052 in a limited edition two-handed watch with their typical skeletonized dial. Well, more than skeletonized, in fact, the 42.7mm case is much larger than the dial of movement, which are connected to the case by four bridges that provide the imagery of a skull and crossbones as seen on pirate ships. The skull and other components are composed of grade 5 titanium, which is an alloy with aluminum and vanadium. The upper and lower jaws hold the ruby of the tourbillon cage. The tourbillon can also be seen through the display case back, where the back of the skull is formed from a bejeweled base plate. In 2012, the retail price of this watch was about $645,000 US. I'll take two, please. Moving further to the extreme of scary watches, at least what I found to be extreme in both complication and cost, we come to the Louis Vuitton Tambour Carpe Diem. This is a 46.8mm pink gold watch. Looking at the dial, we see a snake entwined with a skull. The snake's tail wraps around a diamond, and we have a ruby in the skull's left eye. Finishing out this beautiful high-relief sculpture are the enamel teeth. Note the one gold tooth. This fella must have had a great dentist. So how does one tell time? Simply activate the snake head pusher at the 2 o'clock position on the case, and the movement will run through a complex dance, where the snake's head moves out of the way to reveal an hour indicator in the middle of the skull's forehead. At the same time, the snake's tail pivots to the appropriate spot on the scale to indicate the minutes. But that's not all. The skull's left eye switches between two different monograms, and the jaw opens to show the phrase Carpe Diem between those pearly white teeth. Holy automaton, Batman, that's quite a mechanism. All of this is powered by the caliber LV525 hand-wound movement, which includes a tambour curve GMT flying tourbillon with 100 hours of power reserve. And you get to see this movement through the display case back, which has a black plate in the image of another skull. All of this for just $459,000 US. Any takers? Sure to impress your friends. I do find these watches intriguing. Intriguing not because I'd consider any of these watches for my collection, rather because they have some fascinating design elements and striking wrist presence. While not my style and certainly way out of my price range, I can still appreciate the thought and design that went into creating these pieces. The question that intrigues me the most is what type of watch enthusiast would purchase one of these watches. Wearing an affordable watch with a scary or horror theme is understandable. one only needs to wear it a couple times to justify the purchase price. But the watches I've shown you cannot be had for pocket change. They represent major investments, and considering the unconventional skull imagery of these watches, I could only speculate the type of collector who would own one of these, and if they actually would wear it or just display it prominently. What do you think? Do you know anyone who owns such a watch? It's been fun researching these pieces for this video. I can't say I've ever reviewed any other such watches. But here are some links to other high-end watches with a more conventional style. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.